Long before Chambers Bay was chosen to host the 2015 U.S. Open, a series of major decisions had to fall perfectly into place for this course to take its place in golf history. We dug into our archives and uncovered rare video. Bob Thronson reports on the decision to build Chambers Bay and the visionary who made it happen.
If you could walk in anyone's shoes during the U.S. Open, the snakeskin boots of former County Executive John Ladenburg would be a good choice.
On a clear day, you can see through that slot where the hole is, and you can see the water and the mountains back there.
The 10th hole is his favorite. Imagine having the biggest dream and seeing it come true. Chambers Bay was John Ladenburg's vision. It all started back in 2001.
I got down on the beach and looked at this big, huge piece of property that the public owned, and that beach that had been closed for 100 years, and I thought, we got to get this open to the public.
The massive 930-acre parcel the county bought in 1993 was a gravel mine, a sandy, overgrown wasteland. Ladenburg wasn't a golfer at the time. In fact, he was known for playing slow-pitch softball with his brothers. So what he learned about golf surprised him.
And doing all the research into golf, I realized that we had a unique opportunity here to bring the golf industry here. And the more I found out about the golf industry, the more I loved.
But he didn't just want to build your average municipal course. In this video from September of 2003, Ladenburg made a pitch to the world's best golf course designers.
We want world-class designers and build team to come to this site and see what can be the signature course for Washington State.
78 companies inquired, and golf course architect Robert Trent Jones II was chosen. Ladenburg's goal was to land the biggest tournaments in golf while also meeting the county's growing needs.
We need space to expand our sewer utility, and we have to do something with our wastewater and biosolids. We're also required by state law to reclaim this former gravel mine.
In this public outreach video from 2005, he made his pitch to the citizens of Pierce County.
We can spend about $3 or $4 million to erect fences, install irrigation, and plant natural species that will result in very little public benefit. Or we can reclaim the area with a golf course, trails, and beach access.
As you're looking at the plans, is notice the red line. That's the public open space trail.
There would be many public meetings and political hurdles. But in the end, John Ladenburg's world-class vision for Chambers Bay would get the green light from the Pierce County Council.
I spent virtually all my political capital to get this course built.
Construction on the Scottish Links-style course began in 2006. As Ladenburg told the Jones design team,
build me a course where you can put 80,000 people on the course not in play. And he said, okay, and that's why it's so big. And I said, give us enough space around the course and off the course to host an open.
Early on, Ladenburg and Jones got the attention of the United States Golf Association.
If there are 14,000 courses in America and only 50 or so have ever gotten the U.S. Open, we can't be 99% right. We have to be 100% right.
Chambers Bay opened on June 23, 2007. John Ladenburg had made the public link-style course a reality. Now, he wanted a championship. He sent a formal letter to the USGA asking to host the 2010 U.S. Amateur. Later, when a spot opened in the U.S. Open schedule, Ladenburg sent another letter asking to host the 2015 U.S. Open.
So I knew we were in the running for both, but I really didn't expect to get both.
The call came in early February 2008. Chambers Bay would host both championships.
The next day when that hit the media, I got phone calls from Paris, from Shanghai, from Tokyo. The golf world was stunned. They go, how did you do this? Who are you? Where are you?
Chambers Bay proved to be a firm and fast test for the best amateur golfers in the world, a championship that would be the test run for the 2015 U.S. Open. As Chambers Bay prepares to host the Open, John Ladenburg is content. When the last putt drops on June 21st, 2015, his legacy will make history. Bob Thronson, Pierce County News.